If you change your mind,
take a chance.
I'm the first in line.
Take a chance, take a chance.
Honey, I'm still free.
Take a chance
on me.
Take a chance.
If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go when you're feeling down.
Here we have Volkswagen Transporter, long wheelbase from 2012, T51, two colors, silver and orange. We call it Mandarina. It's been converted by Vans into Campus about 2 years ago. It's got large black alloy wheels. All extras you need on a campsite, including pop-up roof. The engine is 2-liter TDI, very powerful, really good engine, the best on Transporter's T5s. Okay, let's start from inside. Inside, we're also keeping the same matching colors to the outside, which is silver, like that carbon looks like silver with cat eye orange. We have a double rock and roll bed with the compartment underneath. We've got storage with canisters for fresh water and for gray water, a little shelf. Behind here is a big gas bottle, about, don't know, 20 liters, which fits a cooker. Water sink. And we have a fridge, which runs on gas, on 240 and 12 volts. So three sources. You have your little beer opener, which is so important. And there we have Webasto, the heater, which operates from this timer. You're just switching on, adjusting temperature, and it blows hot air to warm up the space. The rock and roll bed. Very easy to operate. You're just pulling this trigger and you just open it this way to close it down. Pull this little strap up and slide it back. The upholstery matching the front seats, so it's the original Volkswagen fabric. The captain swivel seats with ball armrests, and to swivel you just grab the handle, pull it up, and just very easy to swivel. And the table is stored behind the driver seat. We're just hanging it on a rail, blocking the sliders, and open the leg. When the leg is open, you're ready to have your dinner. You can also adjust the table on the rail if you want to have easy access to the fridge, or slide it this way if you need to grab some stuff from under the sink compartment or from the under the bed compartment, where you can have like the plastic boxes and have your dishes and plates and whatever, dry food like pasta or rice, what not necessarily needs to be in the fridge to keep some space for beer in the fridge. Okay, to make it higher, the space, you need to lift up the pop top and lift up the bed.
How to do it?
Firstly, press the button to leave the electromagnets which are on the front. I will show you them later on. They're preventing the roof blowing up when you're driving fast. So undo it, then two straps, open them, and another one, and then very easy, push the roof up. So the roof is up, and then with same, just little push to the bed to open. Now we have enough space to stand up for cooking or whatever you need to do. There is one more compartment for your belongings. Here are the curtains for the front and side windows. The rest is with just normal sliding curtains. On the side of the wardrobe, we have all electric switches and fuses, also the USB sockets, the voltage of the leisure battery, which is stored under driver's seat, and also the old school lighter kind of socket, and 240 which you can use when you are connected on a hookup on the campsite. Inside the wardrobe we have two shelves, and inside the bottom shelf we have a hidden compartment to store your laptop, for example. So you're pressing, I don't know if it's possible to see it, you're pressing the corner there and you're taking this out, and it's enough space to store your laptop here, and just close it, and it's safe and hidden. Okay. On the back, we have quite a lot of space for your luggage. Let me show you from outside. So it's the space is divided by this cargo net, and you have a quite large amount of space. Let me show you like that for your luggage, and also under the rock and roll bed. Here we have two door to the wardrobe, and the bottom part where you can keep your technical stuff. There's always something which you need to take with you from a campsite. If you remove this and hang it, you can sit on this seat and have a view on a cliff, for example. About the stereo, we have Pioneer stereo system with good speakers on the back, good speakers in the front, Bluetooth, and you can connect your smartphone, play the music, do the hands-free phone calls. We have the curtains here. If we need more space for sleeping, we have another bed on top, which we need to pull down and climb up. You can use the seats to use it, to climb up. And also there are the windows which you can open if you want more light and more fresh air. You're just rolling them up. And use a small velcros to hold them up. The bed is designed for two people. Better for children, but I also tested by myself, so over 120 kilos. No problem. Hello there. So under the worktop here you have a little compartment, not a little, quite big one actually, for a big gas bottle. You just slide it this up and swap it. But the bottle lasts for a very, very long time. Probably for a whole season is good enough for a fridge and for cooking.
Large black alloy wheels with brand new tires on the back. There is also a brand new tow bar with a socket for a trailer. And here down underneath is your hookup. So when you are on a campsite, you're just connecting here to the main, to 240, and this feed your battery and all equipment you need to use on 240. Here is your chimney for the gas fridge, when you're operating fridge on gas. And this is the ventilation which you need to open when you use the fridge. So interior, a standard Volkswagen T5.1 with air conditioning. The lever for making the chair up and down. Captain seat with both armrests. Central locking, electric windows, electric mirrors. All together in pretty good condition. There are some small scratches here and there, as you expect from the few years old vehicle.
Under the bonnet. The bonnet is on an air spring, so you don't need to put your rod up. It's very clean. 2-liter common rail TDI Volkswagen engine. There is brand new battery. The starting battery is a new battery, a leisure battery. This is a splitter charger, which split charging between a starting battery and a leisure battery. And also when you're using the leisure battery, it's just a little bit of power from this battery, but never to the point when you cannot start the engine. So it's very, very smart device. So to close the roof, firstly we're closing the top bed, just pulling this gently down. There is still enough space here to operate the roof because the van is a long wheelbase, which is very important. Now then, pulling down by these two handles halfway. Now you're putting the material inside the fabric. It's very important that these two straps, the front and especially back, they are tight, because otherwise the material can go inside the scissor hinges and just cut it. So we're pulling the roof down, it's closed, but we're pushing a little bit fabric here to make the space for the straps. Putting straps through the hooks in the roof and just secure it. One, and then the second one. Okay, when this part is secured, just put the straps so they are not hanging above your head, and just put the material here to make it nicer. Okay, now then, this button here, you're pressing it, the electromagnet starts to work, and then from outside we're just pressing the roof in these places to make the electromagnets working, and the other side as well. Now they are very solid.